First up at 6 a.m, the deepening saga surrounding Princess Kate and that botched Photoshop job on a family picture. Overnight, the Princess of Wales saying she's responsible for doctoring the image, publicly apologising.
Nine's Brett McLeod is in London with more on this story. Brett, more questions being asked by royal fans.
Well, particularly how Kensington Palace allowed this to be released, knowing the entire world would scrutinise this photo and reveal that it was actually photoshopped. Now, you remember it was released for Mother's Day with that message from Kate thanking everyone for their support over the past 2 months since she had abdominal surgery. But agencies raised the red flag first. AFP, Reuters, other large global photographic agencies pointed out there were inconsistencies in parts of the image, showing that it seems to be collated from different sorts of images. That is definitely a no-no when it comes to photographic agencies worried about any digital manipulation. So they took it down. And today, Kate has taken the blame, putting out a statement saying, "Like many amateur photographers, I do occasionally experiment with editing. I wanted to express my apologies for any confusion the family photograph we shared yesterday caused." Then today, for the first time in a very long time, we saw Kate and William together, just in the back of a car, as they were leaving Windsor Castle. She was going off to an undisclosed private appointment, and then William was going off to Westminster Abbey, where there's a Commonwealth Day service. He was accompanying the Queen, Camilla, as they represented the royal family. Another person who was absent because of ill health, as he has cancer treatment, was King Charles, but he made a recorded statement.
"We recognise today that our diversity is our greatest strength. The Commonwealth represents a third of humanity from all regions of the world, with all the different experiences, knowledge and aspirations that this brings."
And we're pretty certain that was actually King Charles. Meantime, Kensington Palace has not responded to many calls for the original photographs of Kate and the kids to be released.
All right, Brett, thank you. Welcome back. Well, after coming under fire for releasing a doctored photo with her children, Princess Kate has issued a public apology on social media, admitting to digitally altering the image.
Let's bring in crisis media specialist Mark Bukowski from London. Mark, good morning to you. You're busy 24 hours over there. The palace says it will not release the original unedited photo. Is that the right move, do you think?
Well, possibly they can't release it because it doesn't exist. I mean, everybody gets very excited about these new AI, generative AI tools, and perhaps a sort of need to present a happy family photo on Mother's Day. It was Mother's Day in the UK yesterday. Usually we see lots of sort of royal couples demonstrating how wonderful and loving their family is. And of course, by not producing a photo, they were probably damned. And now, obviously, producing a fake photo has caused even more problems because the internet is full of conspiracy theories. I, for one, do not believe Kate Middleton has been abducted by aliens. But if you look out there, you'll see thousands of people who do.
I guess that the question everyone asks is why then release the photo if it's going to be digitally enhanced or changed? I mean, this was supposed to put conspiracy theories and rumours to bed. It's done the opposite.
It has done the opposite. They've done the wrong things really, really well. I don't know. I don't know what the thinking is. Sometimes people get so excited about an idea. We call it idea porn in the trade. You don't think of the implications of what you do. And it strikes me there's not a huge amount of joined up thinking, perhaps between the department that runs social media and the media relations department. There's all sorts of theories. But, you know, Kate was one of the most photographed women in the world. I mean, she was adorning front pages in magazines and glosses and newspapers and television spots. I mean, she was the poster girl for the new royal family. So obviously, this is why this speculation. I mean, the woman is recovering from an operation. She deserves the privacy. Her husband is very protective of her. He is clearly not the person who has an altogether harmonious relationship with the media is probably scarred by what happened to his mother. So he has a totally different perspective of how his side of the royal family should be run. So there's loads of reasons why things have happened. But, you know, it's a thankless job, you know, working in that press department. It's a very difficult job and they do the best that they can. But this is a snafu that they will learn to regret. But the royal family are remarkable at respawning, and there's been various crises. I don't think it's up there with one of the really challenging crisis they face even recently. So I think, you know, by this time next week, it'll be over, and at an appropriate time, we will see Kate Middleton again.
I'm not sure it's going to be over that quickly, but I agree with you. It's not that big a deal either, but it's just weird.
It's a modern problem.
That it would happen and that she would try and do it. An excellent use of respawning, by the way.
And snapping.
Thank you, mate. We'll